Toko Dalobang is one of the traditional Betawi games. This game first appeared when the children is shocked to see a lizard that jumps far. Therefore, a game similar to hitting the lizard was made. In this game, there is a division of court and player who are determined by sweep. The group that loses becomes a guard and takes a position behind the line, while the group that wins becomes a player. The game is carried out by piling lizards from the hole as high and far as possible. If caught by the guard, then the player is considered dead and replaced by the next player. However, if the lizard is not caught, the distance of the lizard from the hole will be calculated using a hammer with a value of 1. The next assessment is calculated from the number of strokes. The value of 1 stroke is multiple of 10. The group with the most points is the winner.
Bobak Sodor is a game that is played in groups, where the guard group tries to block the attacking group when they want to cross the line or playing squares. This game first became famous in the area of the island of Java, to be precise, from the Yogyakarta area. The history of the Gobak Sodor game: in ancient times, the soldiers of the homeland played this game. They used it to practice war skills against enemies. This game has two syllables. Gobak means to move freely, while Sodor means a spear that has a sharp spearhead. But in this game, Sodor is the keeper of the axes, which is in the middle of dividing the playing field. This line is used by the other's traffic to narrow the opponent's space. In the game of Gobak Sodor, apart from the need for strategy and cooperation, each team member is also required to be able to pass the linesman team quickly. If not, the line guard team will catch the attacker.
Balogo game is a traditional game native to the Banjar tribe, South Kalimantan. The name Balogo is taken from the word logo, which means playing with tools, with the logo and panapak or champa. This Balogo game can be played individually or in a team. In the past, the Balogo game was believed to be able to measure the luck of their life. Usually, the local people play it after the rice harvest and the Tiwa ceremony, to measure whether they still get fortune after the Tiwa ceremony. In this game, there are cultural values such as the spirit of honesty, selflessness, cooperation, hard work, and deliberation.
Meong-meongan is a traditional game from Bali, which is usually played by children in Bali, accompanied by singing the meong-meong song. This game describes the effort of a cat or meng to catch a mouse or beagle. Meong-meongan is usually attended by 8 or more people, where one person plays the role of beagle and one person plays the role of meng, and the others are tasked with protecting the beagle from meng by forming a circle. Beagle is played inside the circle, while meng is outside the circle. Later, meng will try to get into the circle and catch the beagle. The children who form a circle will also protect the beagle by blocking meng from entering the circle while singing. The game will be finished once meng managed to catch the beagle.
The Pecah Piring game is a traditional game originating from the Pakpak Batak tribe in North Sumatra. As the name implies, this game is played by breaking pile of plates arranged high. The player of this game must prepare the object that will be arranged as a plates and one more object that is used to throw and destroy the arrangement of the plates, such as a ball. The participants of this game are divided into two groups, which are the breakers and the guard. Breaking group members throw the ball toward the arrangement of plates from the determined boundary line. If no one succeeds in breaking it down, it's the other group's turn to be the breaker. However, if the arrangement is successfully solved, the breaking group will try to rearrange it to win the game. But the defending group will try to throw members who are trying to rearrange the plates. If a member of the breaking group is hit by the ball, positions change. The team that managed to put all the pieces back together will win the game.
Rangku Alu is a traditional Indonesian game from Manggarai, Flores, East Nusa Tenggara, using two pairs of bamboo that are moved so that the opponent's feet are caught in the bamboo. The longer the bamboo rhythm and singing will be faster, so players must be agile in jumping. If the player is pinned by the leg, the teams change roles. According to the local language, rangku means striking to objects, while alu is a messing tool made of bamboo. Usually, when the full moon is full, children or teenagers will gather to enliven this game. Parents in Manggarai do the work of tuk elo or pounding agricultural harvest in mutual cooperation, while waiting for their parents to finish work. The children pass the time playing rangku alu, although initially played by children. Slowly, the game became a celebration of agricultural or plantation crops.
Badia badia batuang. In Indonesian, badia means cannon and batuang means big bamboo. This game comes from West Sumatra. In the past, badia batuang was made to commemorate the struggle of Minangkabau heroes against colonialism. This bamboo cannon was also used by the people in the past to scare the peddlers with the same sound as the original cannon. Playing badia batuang must be careful, otherwise the fire will burn the eyebrows or eyelashes. One of the values of playing badia batuang is the value of togetherness, because it is played a lot during the month of Ramadan, and it is played in large places and far from residential areas.
Tunggu-tunggu Belanga is a traditional game from North Sulawesi. Usually, this game is played by the girls. This game uses a kind of putri or incantation, which was originally intended to coax a crying baby. Done by tapping a table or chair with a fist, the louder the blow, the baby's attention will be diverted and silenced. Tumbu-tumbu Belanga is played in group by arranging hands with each other while singing. Usually consists of 5 to 6 people who sit on the porch or anywhere comfortable to play. They will form a circle while sitting cross-legged. When the song ends, the lower fist will open. Then the chain is repeated until the top fist opens.